Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. It's the end of the year again. Many people are like, oh my god, I can't believe it's been a whole year. This has felt like the longest year. I can believe it's been a year because it's been the longest 12 months ever. Oh, I'm sorry. This is the second annual James Welsh Skincare Awards that no one asked for and no one really cares about, but I'm just gonna share it anyway. These are products I have personally loved throughout the whole year. They may not be new, they may not be old. And disclaimer, there are gonna be some products in here that I have done sponsorships with throughout the year, but this is all my own choice. No one's sponsoring this video. I choose brands I want to work with because I love the products. So don't be surprised if you're gonna see a few brands I've worked with before. I've added one or two categories and taken a few away. So let's start with the first new category. And I had to do a first cleanse and a second cleanse because I struggled to pick a cleanser last year. And I kind of realized that cleansers are the products I cycle through the most. So much. So I had to do a first cleanse category. This is the cleansers I usually use as a first cleanse to remove sunscreen, makeup, all that kind of stuff. So easily, I didn't even have to think about this in first place as the first cleanse is the Bioderma Sensibo H2O Micellar Water. I've used so many bottles of this, and I think I've used it a lot because micellar waters were just not interesting to me ever, and they'd always leave a really burning, stinging sensation on my skin. I see people saying like, you're not supposed to leave micellar water on. I saw other people saying it's absolutely fine to. This Bioderma one, this particular color and flavor in pink, is incredible. It's a real no-thrills micellar water, but I believe it was Lab Muffin Beauty Science Michelle who said that this micellar water was purposely made for those who lived in areas where they didn't have full access to water. So it was made for all skin types, all skin conditions, and is supposed to be gentle on the skin. And it leaves me with no stinging sensation whatsoever, removes sunscreen super easily, I don't feel dry after it, I don't feel like tight in the skin. And honestly, it's just now my go-to micellar water. I don't know how much I can go on about a micellar water, like it's kind of boring. But for me, really, it was the non-stinging sensation that just won me over and means I have bottles and bottles of this stuff now. Next category is the second cleanse. So once my sunscreen's off, I then go in usually with a light foaming face wash, and it has to be my most used cleanser of the year, the Naturium Niacinamide Gelée. It's just like a soft pudding for your skin. It's so nice and so gentle. It's a nice light foam. And what I love about this cleanser is we have 3% niacinamide, so a good amount of niacinamide. And it's so non-drying that you can just apply this like a mask, leave it on for a few minutes, and then kind of let the niacinamide do its job, and then add some water, foam up, then rinse away. If you want to use it as a double cleanse, I like to apply it onto dry skin, then just start wiping around from there and then rinse away. It's just such a nice, gentle cleanser. I feel like nowadays cleansers don't strip your skin anyway, but this one in particular just feels so... I always say like my skin feels untouched after it. It feels like I haven't put it through any kind of like rubbing or scrubbing or rinsing. They say it's an essence-like cleanser. I get that. It's just got this lightweight cloudiness to it. Not only does it make it a real pleasure to use, it's like a nice experience if you're into that with your skincare, but it's really, really good at genuinely cleansing away things like sunscreen, makeup, whilst just being gentle on the skin too. It's a cleanser that seems to just hit all the right spots for me. The next category is exfoliants. And of course, for me, it has to be an exfoliating toner, an exfoliating liquid. And like, I feel like a recent discovery, but one that I can't get enough of, is the Peach Slices Acne Exfoliating Toner with Salicylic Acid. But it also has some AHA in it as well. It's an amazing all-rounder. It's got 2% salicylic acid in, and honestly, it's a good dupe for the Paula's Choice Salicylic Acid Cleanser. A genuine dupe. I always try to dupe it, because Paula's Choice BHA is great. It's iconic for a reason. For me, however, I don't quite like the little tacky feeling it leaves, and it's sold out all the fucking time. But its Peach Slices one just seems to go on like water. Do you know what I mean? And then you can't feel it on your skin after, which I prefer to a slight tacky layer. It's got allantoin, cica, cucumber, so it's calming, it's soothing alongside your AHAs and BHAs. The AHAs being glycolic and lactic acid, and then salicylic acid in here as well. It's a gentle exfoliant with good percentage actives that I can use in a routine without having to make a fuss about it. It goes on, feels like water. I don't have to stand there doing this, waiting for it to dry down before I go into the next step. It's just been an amazing, amazing exfoliating toner. Next up is the toner. And actually, all these toners are mists. Mists and toners are the same thing. It's just a hydrating type liquid. And for me, it has to be the Beautiani Infusing Collagen Concentrate Mist. I've gone through these over and over and over and over. They're convenient. They're like water, but with benefits. Obviously, we have collagen in here, and their own description says that it has anti-wrinkle benefits. It doesn't really. All it is the collagen makes it nice and moisturizing. We have glycerin in here, really, really nice humectant. Niacinamide. Aloe, so it's nicely like soothing and hydrating. And then Saccharomyces ferment, which is supposedly an anti-aging ingredient. Overall, it's just like an essence-type misty toner, like an all-in-one. We do have an essence category that I use between every step of my routine to help products penetrate into the skin better and just to give my skin that extra boost of hydration. All in a really convenient tiny bottle that spritzes super easily. I do love a good mist. The next category is essences, and I'll be honest, I've not really used any other essences most of the year other than the COSRX snail ones, which I absolutely love, and they do come in second place. But the real standout for me, again, kind of like a latecomer to the year, is the Gothamista and Saro de Rue essence. This, I wouldn't expect anything less from Gothamista Rene, but it feels like luxury. It's a real, like, it's not just a skincare product that you put on, it's a whole experience. They themselves say that this is like a serum, toner, essence all in one. And really, we're getting to know that toners, essences, serums tend to all blend into one category at the moment. It's formulated with 62% enhanced black ginseng extract, which is like a traditional Korean medicinal herb. I think it has some really good anti-aging properties. We've got 4% niacinamide in here as well. Everything has niacinamide in, but you know, it's nice to have it in something like your essence-y serum stage. That's where I personally prefer it. This is an essence based on traditional Korean medicine, as we spoke about, which is very Gothamista for me. Very reminiscent of, you know, some of her favorites, some of the collections that she puts together with other brands. We have ceramides, essential fatty acids. It really is kind of like, if you want it to be, the only kind of in-between cleanser and moisturizer product that you really need. A little bit on the prices side, but again, if it's the one step in between cleanser and moisturizer that you're going to use, it's kind of worth the money. I'm really, really loving this product. The number one serum has to go to Experiment and the Super Saturated Serum. Now, I know it's only just launched, but I mentioned in a few previous videos, I've been trying this since May of this year, so I have been using it for the best part of a year. Well, 6 months, actually. June, July, August, September, October, November. Yeah, about 6-7 months. And if you know me and you know kind of my relationship with hyaluronic acid, you know that I prefer glycerin as a hydrator. And this serum has 30% glycerin in it. I believe it's one of the only serums out there with this high percentage of glycerin. I think there might be Serum Kind serum that's kind of up there too. But they say on their website, not only is this a hydrator, but it has barrier replenishing properties and soothing properties. They really kind of like highlight glycerin as an underappreciated hydrating ingredient, which I think a lot of the skincare community agree with. But again, we have some of my favorite ingredients in here. We have prickly pear extract, which if it was up to me would be in all of my products. I love prickly pear. It's nice and moisturizing, soothing. We of course have niacinamide, polyglutamic acid, another overlooked hydrator. An experiment says that focuses more like the dewy appearance of your skin while glycerin goes in. Polyglutamic acid has a higher molecular weight, so it kind of works on the surface. And that this serum gives you that nice glow. It's a little bit sticky, but that means it works perfectly with their reusable silicone mask because it just clings to your face. And when you take it off, you are super hydrated, super saturated. You know, your skin just feels and looks incredible. I love Experiment as a brand. I love everything they stand for. And I want more products from them. I really want a moisturizer from them. I just feel like it'll be incredible. Like, please. I know this took a couple of years to make though, so hopefully they're already making something, or we might have to wait another couple of years. But I'm fine with that. This super saturated was well worth the wait. Let's talk about eye products. Eye creams get a bad rep. Do you need them? No. Are they nice to use? Yes, I think so. Some people may benefit from them. So an eye cream is something that within the last 2 years, I've been focusing on using a lot more. When I was in my late 20s, a lot of my skincare community friends in their like late 30s were like, start using an eye cream. please, or you'll regret it. So I did, and this kind of is no change to last year. But my favourite eye product has to be the Dew Skin Forever Eye Masks. It's just the only eye product you need, in my opinion, along with your favourite eye cream, serum, even your moisturiser. The way it just kind of clings onto your skin, better than any one-use eye mask or eye patches. And you can really see the instant results of like plumper under eyes, lighter under eyes. It's just worth every penny for me. And then you can obviously reuse these and reuse these and reuse these with good care. They have just launched an eye cream as well, which I literally started using yesterday. So I'm excited to share a bit more about that. If I like it, I think I will do. I've tried many, many reusable eye patches and they are just not the same. They're nowhere near as good as these. And I surprisingly just want to touch on number two, which was the Kim Kardashian, the skin eye cream. It's so nice. It's really nice, really expensive, but I know there's a dupe out there somewhere for it. I just don't try enough eye creams. Let's move on to the mask. And for me, this was going to be, again, Experiments reusable silicone mask. So I put that as my second, when really it's kind of a joint first with Peach Slice's Snail Rescue Intensive Wash Off Mask. I have been loving this for the redness in my skin. It gives this instant cooling sensation that kind of like calms down my skin, cools down redness in my skin. It's great with my rosacea. I take this everywhere with me if I'm going away, because if I'm going away, I'm going to see people. So I like to cool and calm my skin before going out. We have 95% snail mucin in here, which is great for helping moisturize the skin, help with barrier function, cica to help calm the skin, licorice for calming and kind of like evening tone. And it's in this really nice jelly texture that just clings to your skin, which I love because it means I can walk around and do things while I got this mask on my face for like 15 minutes without it like falling and glooping off my face. Rinse it away and your skin is left so soft. This has just been a really pleasurable mask to use where I see instant benefits and can appreciate the long-term benefits as well. Lip product. So I kind of like, I go through a lot of lip products this year and my favorites have kind of shifted and changed. And this is my current lineup with my first place going to In Beauty Project Candy Apple Lip Oil. This is not like a lip oily oil. It's kind of more like a balm meets oil with, I'm a sucker for like flavors. I love different flavors. Their mystery flavor is one of my favorites as well. But the candy apple is the one that I've just been using nonstop every single night. It sits by my bed. In Beauty is a brand that's gone pretty viral over on TikTok, or is at least popular over on TikTok, that I feel doesn't get as much love over here on YouTube. I feel like that's kind of like a demographic thing, but their products are really, really good and I hope more people discover it. So according to their website, their lip oils contain natural red root oil, which is a fermented oil from a chicorin plant, for healing and moisturizing and visibly kind of soothing chapped and cracked lips. Fermented pomegranate, they say, gently exfoliates. Apple extract, rich in antioxidants, helps hydrate the lips. Then plant-based plumping complex to help plump the appearance of lips immediately over time. This is the first time I've looked at the ingredient list. Do I haven't even bothered to look, because what I like about this product is I hydrate my lips and I put this over and it kind of like seals my lips in and I wake up with nice moisturize lips. I've not even looked at it, to be honest. But it's got just that subtle tint to it that if you like wearing makeup and a gloss, you can wear this out as like a gloss. So yeah, I'm trying a lot more of their products at the moment, so hopefully I have more to share about this brand in the future. So moisturizer this year, I've done a morning moisturizer and an evening moisturizer because they are very different for me. And again, I struggled to pick one. So I think no surprise here really that first place AM morning moisturizer goes to Glow Recipes Glow Pink Juice Moisturizer. The perfect combination of being light enough for the daytime, yet moisturizing enough for it to not just sink into my skin and disappear and leave me feeling drier throughout the rest of the day. Of course, with watermelon and antioxidant, hyaluronic acid to help hydrate the skin, glycerin, we have licorice root extract. It's just the perfect lightweight daytime moisturizer that's going to give you this healthy, dewy glow. If you don't like overly dewy skin, this is a perfect moisturizer to go for if you like that hydration and a little bit of dew. And I talked about this to death. You know I love it. Let's move on to the PM moisturizer, the evening routine moisturizer, and first place has to go to the Astura Atobarrier 360 cream. As I always say, this is my CeraVe. It smells a little bit like PVA glue, but there's something very kind of like modern about this packaging and the brand itself that feels less boring than CeraVe. It's got all your essential ceramides in, and really it's just a nice thick ceramide enriched barrier caring cream to use in the evening before bedtime. If you're dry, you're gonna love this during the day. If you're oily, they do a gel cream alternative, which is just as good. Not massively fancy, does the job it needs to do. If your skin is fucked, this is gonna help heal your skin in no time. I absolutely love this cream. It's calming, it's soothing, you have fatty acids in here as well. It's everything your skin needs to help on its journey to healing your skin. Spot treatment, flash through this one because it's not changed. It's the same as last year. First place goes to Rosen Breakout Spot Treatment. It's just like, whenever I use this, people are like, but it's got peppermint in. I know. It's just, it's for me, it's just a really simple spot paste that just works. Like, I can never be without this. And if they stop making it, I don't know what I'm going to do. Because if I have a breakout, this goes on the next day. And I have to say this whenever I talk about this product. The next day, my spot is gone or significantly less. The redness goes down. I think it's due to the zinc oxide in here. The redness is gone. It's flattened. There's no whitehead. It doesn't look angry or aggressive. It is just the best spot treatment I've ever used ever in my life. Ever. Sunscreen was an easy one for me this year. I think I enjoyed a lot of sunscreen brands, especially the top like three that you see now. But Undefined and their R&R Sun Serum was just the best sunscreen I've used, basically. You know, I've been looking for a tinted sunscreen. I think when obviously you have much darker skin, it's hard to find a tinted sunscreen. When you have lighter skin like mine, but still a little bit brown, it's hard to find a tinted sunscreen that isn't orange or yellow on your skin. And this was just like the perfect combination of the right tone to fit my skin tone, the right glowiness, the right glossiness, had no horrible features of stingy eyes, stinging skin, and the way it makes my skin look, I just love. Whenever I wear this, people ask me if I'm wearing makeup, and I have to be like, no, just a tinted sunscreen. I've got some amazing ingredients in here. So it's 12% zinc oxide, niacinamide, and then we have tremella mushroom as well, which I believe is a really nice moisturizing ingredient. There's blue light protection in here as well, so genuine blue light protection from the sun, not from your screens. We know the difference. It's just one of the best sunscreens I've ever used and suits my skin perfectly. Perfectly. We have a new category, and that is body care, because I have to say that Solterre, their body washes, all their body washes are just the most unique fragrances I think I've ever smelled from any kind of cosmetic category. They're in this, again, like this serum weight, which is like a lightweight, jelly-like, lightly foaming, but foaming enough body wash that just, you step out the shower and you don't feel like you need to moisturize. I do, but it leaves your skin feeling nicely washed and nourished and not dried out. A little bit of this stuff really goes a long way. I'm one of those people that when something comes in a pump ball, I'm like pumping it out on my loofah as much as possible because I feel like I need to get the best foam when I'm showering myself. But with this Solterre wash, you do one long, slow pump, kind of like slivers out, and that's enough just to completely foam up and cover your whole body. And the fragrances alone are enough just to get this body wash. I love them. Naturium are second, Fleur were almost third, but then Tambourines, kind of like beat them to it. Just because I've been using them a little bit more than any other kind of like brand, but just because I've been using them more than Fleur, but Fleur again, with their fragrances, like that's another brand I'm looking forward to seeing what they come out with. So let's talk about the biggest fail of the year. And to be honest with you, this was a tough one. I feel like a lot happened, but not massively enough to be like, oh, you know, you failed in 2022. What I would say the biggest fail of the year at the moment is Revolution Beauty's road to failure. They're going downhill. Whilst we still don't know the full story, I am interested and but slightly nervous to see where they're going to be this time next year. If they are going to be, who's going to buy them out possibly? If they changed up their brand? I don't know. I have a whole video about it here, like about why I really truly dislike Revolution Beauty that I want you to check out instead of me talking about it now. I want to stay a bit more upbeat. Let's talk about products that I think are going to go viral next year. And this is SPF in the form of balm, so like tinted sticks. So SPF makeup, sunscreen in makeup, but sunscreen sticks that are tinted. You know what I mean? I think we're seeing a rise in people wanting to figure out other ways that they can protect their skin from the sun, but also reapplying sunscreen in easy ways. And tinted sunscreen sticks are kind of the way to do it. We're seeing a lot of sunscreen sticks going viral at the moment. They have been throughout the year. And I feel like the next step is that kind of like sunscreen stick makeup, which again makes it easy to reapply makeup over sunscreen because it is sunscreen. SPF lip balms, I feel like people are just discovering you need to protect your lips as well. So whilst everyone did go crazy for sunscreen, which is a good thing and a bad thing in my opinion, because of the sheer like addiction some people seem to have to it and fear of going outside, I feel like people are interested in other ways to protect themselves against the sun. And I think we're gonna see that throughout 2023. I want to talk about the overall brand of the year for me. And again, this was a tough one because I have my firm favorites like COSRX and Glow Recipe, which are gonna be my favorites all year, every year. You know, they are a brand that I absolutely love. But I've got to say that I think my favorite brand of the year and one that I've been using the most probably for the last 6 months is Peach Slices. I think a lot of people are discovering Peach Slices and their Snail line, their acne line, they're really reasonable and affordably priced products. And I think people again are enjoying full formulated products. People don't really care about these 1% products anymore. People are kind of being less and less interested in brands like the Inculus, the Ordinary, Minimalist. People want to see full formulated products. And I think Peach Slices do a really good job at kind of encompassing interesting ingredients, ingredients that work really, really well. The ingredients like niacinamide, hyaluronic acid, exfoliants that people are usually using in these single percentage serums and bringing them back into really nice formulated everyday use products. Peach Slices is a brand that whilst you may have only seen the last couple of months on my channel, I've been using throughout the year and that's kind of how it goes. You know, I got to experiment with these products and you'll definitely be seeing me using more next year. For me, their redness relief line has been a great help with my rosacea, especially the azelaic acid, a great dupe again for a Paula's Choice azelaic acid. It's a lot less stingy, a lot less irritation with the same kind of outcome. So out of all of these products, I've got to have a one winner, a product of the year, one that if any out of all these products, I really, really recommend you'd go and check out. And for me, it has to be Experiment Super Saturated. Everyone's so fucking bored of hyaluronic acid serums. We don't need another one. We don't need another one. But people like to be hydrated. And to see a serum like Super Saturated that is really, really hydrating without just having five different types of hyaluronic acid in, it's a new take on something that everyone loves, which is hydration. What I also love about this product is the thought that's gone behind it and the fact that it's possibly made to work with another one of their products. I love brands that do products that you can use separately or do to come together as a package. They make the perfect package. I just feel like, well, I know there's a lot of thought that has gone into this serum, a lot of care. The packaging's perfect. I love Experiment's whole visual thing as well. I love a brand who has an amazing like visual story, a good concept. We know I love a concept and amazing products that just work. And that for me is Experiment as a brand in whole. So there we go. There we have the skincare, James Welch Skincare Awards 2022. Let me know if you've loved any of these products as well. Let me know some of your top award-winning products of this year in the comments down below. You can check out some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.